हेलो गाइस गाइस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक रिकवरेबिलिटी ऑफ शेड्यूल। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन ऑल द सेक्शन रिगार्डिंग द सीरियलाइजेबिलिटी। नाउ डिस्कस दिस सेक्शन। रिकवरेबिलिटी ऑफ शेड्यूल सेज दैट कि इफ देयर इज अ नंबर ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शन इन अ शेड्यूल, वी हैव अ शेड्यूल एंड वी हैव एटलीस्ट टू ट्रांजैक्शन और थ्री ट्रांजैक्शन और मे बी मोर, बट एटलीस्ट टू ट्रांजैक्शन एंड वन ट्रांजैक्शन इज रीडिंग सम अदर्स अपडेटेड इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वन ट्रांजैक्शन इज रीडिंग सम अदर्स राइट इंस्ट्रक्शन, दैट्स हियर। And after that, if there is a failure or error, but after some time or executing some instruction, the failure comes or some error comes out here, then if we are able to return in consistent state, then it is recoverable schedule. Otherwise, it is irrecoverable schedule. Then after the some failure, if we are able to return to the same position where we have started, or if we are not return to the same position, but the state should be consistent state at that time, then it is a recoverable schedule. Otherwise, it is a irrecoverable schedule. Okay, so let's discuss some example, then it will be clear out. We have this schedule and we have this another schedule. So this schedule contains two transaction which consists this read operation then write operation. Okay guys, then after that this transaction T2 read this value, but this read value is updated by first in transaction T1. That means it is an updated value be transferred to this transaction. Then after that, let's suppose it commit its transaction and it commits its transaction as well. And if there is a failure, then what will happen? Will it roll back or not? No, because it has already committed, both of them has already committed their transaction. That's why it will keep under the consistent state. So that's why it is called recoverable schedule. Okay guys, because no data will be lost and it does not have to move to somewhere, so it is a recoverable schedule. Now suppose it does not exist, commit does not exit here, commit does not exit here, and there is a failure at this point, then what will happen? Suppose it is again reading this updated value. Okay, then if there is a failure, then it will roll back. Okay guys, but it has already read this updated value, so in that case we will also roll back this one, so this schedule will always be in that case in a recoverable schedule. Okay guys, because we have returned to the consistent state after rollback from this transaction and from this transaction. So this transaction will move to this point and this transaction will also move to this point. That means the starting point, and that is also known as the consistent state of this schedule. Okay guys, so this is the recoverable schedule. Now move to a second example. There are the two transactions again and same things are here. This read is having the value of this updated value. This transaction T2 commit first. It is not committing, it is committing first. Then there is a failure. Okay guys, then what will happen? This transaction will roll back. Okay, this transaction will roll back, but it will not because it has committed. Then what will happen? Suppose there is a value is 50 suppose, and this write value has updated this value to 100 suppose, then but it will return to the again to 50. Okay guys, because of the rollback, but it is reading this value only 100 here, so there will be an inconsistency here because it is here 50 and it is here 100, so there will be inconsistency. That means it is a irrecoverable schedule. So this is the recoverable and irrecoverable schedule. In the next video, we will discuss the topic cascadeless schedule and cascade. हमारे पास there will be a cascade problem. We will be having some cascade problem or cascade rollback. Then we will discuss the cascadeless schedule. Okay guys, so get ready with that videos also. And guys, please subscribe this channel and share, and please share, and please like this. Guys, please like and share this videos and subscribe the channel. Thank you.